so they're going to be way more comfortable in here and climbing all over this thing, hanging upside down, falling in the water probably. They're pretty amazing climbers. Their mom is here at the zoo. She lives over in our Asian Forest Sanctuary area. We actually have six adults
over
here.
Let's go see the ant eaters.
Yeah, they are separated from their mom for a couple reasons. One reason is it's recommended that they be hand-reared because the hand-reared cubs have proven to be better display animals in the zoo, and they are breeding. And we can go in and intervene, so their mom was hand-reared. She did not take very good care of the litter, and we're able to have the trainers go right in to her and get the cub. Or they actually let one cub stay in for 4 hours, and the mom never let her feed from them. And then the mom with the first litter last year, she overgrown, we think, the little female that was born, and bit her tail, and so part of her tail had to be nobody really knows because they don't know anything about this series out in the wild. Only a few studies have been done. Nobody's ever seen cubs this size with an adult out in the wild. It's amazing they don't know a lot about these animals.
Wow. Are they only from Thailand or
you find them throughout Malaysia? Thailand, Borneo, you can find them in Sumatra. So they each had a litter last year, and this year Nashville had two litters, and Chanel had one litter, and then we had one litter. And so what will happen is a decision will be made as to who will be paired with whom, and then they'll be mixed up, and then they will go off to other zoos for breeding programs. We do have, there is a system in place, it actually is way more involved, just goes all with their genetics and everything, we imported, the United States imported,
All right, one more minute, you guys, and we'll go get a snack, okay?
Five pops.
Or even lunch, absolutely.
And so three of them are here at our garden. And then
lunchtime if we're hungry.
I'm hungry.
These cats don't do very well.
No, we're not getting
there. At all. And most zoos that have bred them where they were not hand reared, they just become closed off. People's strollers, everything scares them to death. And, places will make these beautiful enclosures for them, so they do like to climb really high and everything. And then they end up getting pulled off of exhibit because of complaints that people never get to see them. And we found that when you spend time with them and work with them and they come out here, again, all of you guys there really help them, the toys, everything just makes them better adjusted cats. And the ones that we did raise last summer and are off at other zoos are excellent exhibit cats.